Michigan Magazine is kept on the road by our many Michigan friends. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare, a winning combination. Cops and Donuts. Thunder Bay Resort, a destination for all seasons with special events and packages. Thunder Bay Resort in Hillman. All aboard, ride on the Michigan Asabo Valley Railroad, a quarter-scale passenger train through the beautiful scenic landscape of northern Michigan, just south of Fairview. Now open weekends and holidays. Visit them online or call them now. Experience the beauty, artistry, and taste of northern Michigan. Come to Amish Country Natural Products on Mount Tom Road, north of Mile, just off M33. From arts and crafts to fresh foods and vegetables, all natural, all local, all good. Stop by and get acquainted with Amish Country Natural Products, 1454 North Mount Tom Road, Mile. For home medical and healthcare products, visit Rose City Drug at 2640 North M33, just south of Rose City city limits. Rose City Drug has a complete diabetic department, including shoes. Serving Michigan for over 20 years, Rose City Drug, Rose City. Hale Hardware, your do-it center in Hale, Michigan. Much more than a regular hardware store, providing everything you need for whatever your project is, along with a knowledgeable sales staff to get her done. Serving northern Michigan since 1946. Hale Hardware, south of M65 at Ainsley in Hale. On this week's Michigan Magazine, we explore a Michigan distillery, Uncle Don's Apple Pie Distillery. Yep, Michigan is one of the top states in the U.S. for the creation of new small distilleries producing world-class spirits. And then, speaking of spirits, Halloween is right around the corner, and we're bringing back the amazing Ray Villafane, Jack-O-Lan artist. Since our visit with Ray when he was an art teacher at Bellaire High School, his name has become world-famous for his incredible carvings. Stay tuned, it's all coming up next on Michigan Magazine. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare. What began as a crazy idea among 9 police officers to purchase the historic Clare City Bakery quickly became an international phenomenon, carrying on a Michigan tradition with delicious donuts, pies, pastries, breads, original coffee, and more. Plus a full menu at the new adjacent traffic stop diner. Downtown Clare, a winning combination. Cops and Donuts. Nowadays, the spirit of Michigan is proliferating into the spirits of Michigan, with state licensing and regulations opening up avenues for small still operations in the state. There are more and more world-class products coming out of the backroads of Michigan. We ran across one such operation spreading its wings, establishing itself on Main Street in Cadillac. To be exact, 805 North Mitchell Street in Cadillac. It's Uncle Don's Apple Pie Craft Distillery. When you visit the drinkmichigan.org website, you'll see Uncle Don's listed as a small craft distillery featuring country cocktails, shining spirits, and Big Gun Vodka. The cocktail flavors include old-fashioned apple, fuzzy peach, black cherry, blueberry, and raspberry. Shining spirits is their signature 80 proof. The Big Gun Vodka is Uncle Don's 100 proof. The state of Michigan has been encouraging this fairly new industry to improve the state's economic climate. Some state universities have even included courses in the arts. Of distilling and marketing. With a green light given to on-site sales, there are reportedly 14 licensed artisan distilleries in the state. Michigan is second only to California. Artisan distilleries are where liquor is produced, bottled, and served. It takes a dedicated craftsperson to maintain and grow a small distillery with a loyal clientele, and Uncle Don seems to have found his calling. On this edition of Michigan Magazine, glad to meet you, Don. I tell you what, we've been on the trail with all sorts of wine and beer hops, trails, whatever, but now we've got an amazing thing happening in Michigan, especially here in Cadillac, and you have got a distillery.
We're a small distillery, and we're at the leading edge of it.
You have what you are called stills, right, more or less? And are they any different than the moonshiner stills way back in the hills of Kentucky or West Virginia, or are they pretty much the same concept? Or tell us a little bit about the operation.
Well, it's the same concept, but the only problem is we're doing it legal, which is a good thing. But the thing is when with ours, we're not in the woods, and we're not, you know, we're regulated, you know, And
a lot more sanitary.
Oh, sanitary isn't the word. We have a lady here that works with us, and she's she keeps right on top of it for us. But I see it. It's going to be it's a good thing for everybody. But the thing is, with a distillery, a lot of people relate us with wineries, breweries,
right.
But they don't understand that there's a different world,
and
what they can do, we can't do.
Okay.
As long as we have that tower sticking up and the booze coming out, we can go outside and advertise. For us, we've been at it for about a little over 2 years to get our licenses and everything to get going. When I say a small distillery, that means we can make up to 50,000 gallons a year of vodka.
Okay.
Then after 50,000 gallons, now that's a large distillery. And as far as I know, there's only one like that in the state of Michigan. And we're on the leading edge of the small distillery, and I'm quite proud of that. What we've got here is I started out with a kind of a potato vodka, and we've backed off that a little bit. That's going to be a new line that's going to be coming out in the future. But right now what we have is an old German recipe, which I've got it from Czechoslovakia, some relatives on email. And my recipe that I originally started with is real close to it. I mean, it's so close, it's unbelievable. Our process is quite lengthy on our vodka. To boil our own water, we have to get up to over 200 degrees. So we know it's pure water. No contamination in it at all, because that'll kill off your yeast and your enzymes. So once that's all done, then we got it cooled down to room temperature. And then once we get it down to room temperature, now we start with our yeast and our sugar and our other wash that we have, which is kind of like a little secret, I guess. Everybody has their own.
Little trade secret there.
And it turns out pretty good. And that takes from 7 to 14 days per batch. And then it takes about, you know, we run off about a gallon and a half an hour of vodka. It'll run anywhere from 150 to 190 proof. Then we have to, you know, cut it and run it back through again. And so, I mean, it's to make a gallon of vodka, you're probably looking at about 14 days.
What in the world got you into this? I mean, what was your inspiration? I mean, you must have had the inkling that this is something that I could do better than anybody else.
About 10, 12 years ago, and about, it's been about 12 years now, I was out in New York working. I do pipeline for a living. And by doing the pipeline for a living, it was a rainy day, and everybody's sitting around the campfire there at Trailer Park, and and we couldn't work. And I went ahead there, and the guy passed around his jug. I wouldn't let my dog get close to it. It was bad. Yeah, it was real bad. So I thought, well, heck, I can do something better than that. So I got messing with it. It took me a couple months, and all of a sudden, I've got it. And what it was my great aunt's apple pie recipe. The only thing that's not in it is the lemon and the crust. So if you think you can have my apple pie with a fork and knife, you're sadly mistaken. But it's good when you warm it up, pour it over ice cream, whatever. It's fantastic. You don't blame me? Try it yourself and you'll find out.
Even though I'm not a partaker of spirits, I took Uncle Don's word for it. The distillery on Mitchell Street had the aroma of freshly baked apple pies. It was unique. Our visit with Uncle Don was an inspiring story of determination and success. But before you go out and start building your own still, be aware Michigan is still a regulated state.
Between a non-regulated state and a regulated state is two different worlds. In the state of Michigan, it's quite tough.
But you persevered, and you're here today.
Yeah, I'm here today, and I've got a license. And they don't—if they want to take a look at them, they're hanging on the wall.
I don't see any revenueers outside.
No.
So, what's your hopes and dreams? What do you plan on doing?
Well, I just want to expand,
let
the people know that what we have here, and it'll help out the community, and help us out too, the boot, you know.
And that it has. Uncle Don's products are being distributed everywhere. And Uncle Don was quick to point out his one employee, Amanda, is a vital part of the equation. She takes great pride in being a key part of quality control and so thankful for the job. She was previously a stay-at-home unemployed mom, and now she is one, if not the only, woman distiller in the state of Michigan. Congratulations. For more information on Uncle Don's Apple Pie Distillery, check out their official website. Uncle Don's, 805 North Mitchell Street in Cadillac. Michigan Magazine is being brought to you in part by Discount Foods Downtown Mile. Find national name brand foods and merchandise at sharply discounted prices. Shop the smart way and please the family without breaking the budget. Discount Foods Downtown Mile. The Michigan-made rebounding mailbox pull. Never again worry about the winter snowplow taking out your mailbox with this ingenious rebounding pull. Your mailbox takes a hit and keeps coming back year after year. Call now or visit their website, toughmailboxes.com. Remembering good times and great food, Frank and Lisa invite you to Tin Lizzie's in Mile for a blast back to the 50s and 60s when food was made from scratch, including home-ground Angus burgers. A full menu of great food and good memories await you at the new Tin Lizzie's of Mile. Rose Valley Winery on Beechwood Road in Rose City. See what thousands are raving about, creating a delicious variety of award-winning Michigan wines. Stop by and taste for yourself. The taste of Michigan is yours at Rose Valley Winery.
Audubon, Michigan brings with it the time-honored tradition of jack-o'-lantern carving. So it was only a matter of time till the tradition of simple carving turned into a more elaborate fine art through the creativity of a northern Michigan man, Ray Villafane of Bellaire. Ray teaches art classes K through 12 at Bellaire area schools in northwestern lower Michigan and found pumpkins to be an abundant medium in the area. That discovery has developed into an annual display by Ray and his art students of virtual three-dimensional works of carving art. Michigan Magazine visited Bellaire High School one early autumn morning to witness Ray's talent and some of the extraordinary work his 9th through 12th grade students were creating. Shortly before class, we talked with Ray about how he first discovered the potential fine art in pumpkins.
About 5 years ago, I was living in Ohio and I brought a pumpkin home to carve, and I just got graduated a couple years prior, graduated college, and I figured, well, you know, why not, you know, I used to just do the triangles on them like everyone else, and So I said, let me try carving it like I would, like I say, clay or wood, and I took a knife to it, and it didn't look like these, but it kind of, I mean, it came out all right. At the time, I thought it was neat, and that was that, and a few years later, moved up here, and kid wanted to know if he could paint the pumpkin in class. I said, yeah, bring it in. And they brought a couple in, and I said, well, let me try carving it. I tried to do it again, and it was a little better. And before you know it, other students liked this, they brought in more pumpkins. And I experimented with various tools, and what turned into a couple of pumpkins escalated into students bringing in too many pumpkins. I would come up to the classroom, and I still do. Usually there's a pumpkin, there's pumpkins, either students I don't even have or don't know, standing with the door waiting, you know, asking if I could carve a pumpkin for them, or there's usually a pumpkin there with a little note, Mr. Villafane, can you carve this one for me?
But I've noticed also, it doesn't matter what the size or what the configuration is of this pumpkin, you don't use stencils and you don't use automatic or powered tools.
What I use is a metal loop, similar to like what a clay loop.
So that's one of the essential tools.
Yeah, this is 90% of it's done with this. Then there's some smaller versions, the store-bought. These are, like I said, working for clay. Various shapes for different areas, you know, and as you do more of these, you kind of know which one for what need you have. I mean, some are round, this triangle, and that one's kind of squared off.
Okay.
And then like a paring knife. Sharp end is right here, as opposed to there's a dull side there, and this is what I'll do at the very end. Pumpkins are kind of translucent, so you need to exaggerate all the shadows on it, or else the light, it won't capture the shadows of a face. So you want to get in a little deeper with the smile marks and in various areas. So I use a paring knife there. But okay. I'd say most of it's done with this.
Most of it's done with that.
Yeah.
And when you start a project like this, do you know right offhand, when you look at the pumpkin, the figurine, or what the pumpkin is shaped like, do you know in your mind what you want that to be?
Sometimes. I buy pumpkins wholesale from a farm, Bolt's farm here in Ellsworth, and I get to walk the pumpkin patch before the pumpkins are picked and pick out which ones I want.
And he saves them for you.
Yeah, and what I look for are ones that are heavy for its size, which means it'll have a thick meat to it.
Thick skin.
Yeah, and I look for something that has got a point coming towards it. I don't usually use the ones typically everyone wants, the perfect round ones. They're hard to put a face on because they tend to be flat.
No character.
I need a point on it, so if I want to get the face, I can go around, get the tip of the nose, and work around if I'm doing a person.
Uh-huh.
Usually I get something with a point, or once in a while you find a pumpkin that's got some, with a vine, makes some deep cuts into it, and I always grab those because you can make kind of lips out of those where the vine goes, and you kind of make a face. And there's lots of things you can kind of make out of them. You just got to look at them for a little while. But I don't just pick up a pumpkin and say, okay, I'm going to make, or say, I want to make a pirate and just pick up any pumpkin. There is a lot of choosing involved, and I can kind of see when I look at the pumpkin, is that going to be the shape I need? Yeah. And as I work, sometimes it changes. While I'm middle of carving, if the pumpkin tends to want to do something else, I kind of let it go that way.
Do you have in mind, though, when you start, are these supposed to be characters that you have seen, or are these characters that you just let the hands and the flow of the mind just...
I'll use a mirror. They don't look like me, but I'll use a mirror to get some of the... So I get the gesture of the face. Like this one here, but I'll use a mirror for some of the marks on where some of the wrinkles, I'll make that similar face, and I kind of look for those wrinkles in it to see where they go, and it makes for a much more believable pumpkin face.
Well, this is the season. I mean, this is seasonal, definitely. I mean, it's what? You start this, what, in September or October?
Yes, and as soon as I get pumpkins, I start itching to do it. And I'm kind of glad that they don't last. A lot of people say, isn't there something you could spray on it or do something to it?
But fresh idea for the following year.
Yeah, I kind of like, it's like ice carving, you know? Yeah. I mean, you'd rather have an ice swan rather than a plastic one for a wedding. And I think the same thing with pumpkins. If you seal them, it's fun, and it's also fun to see them go. They take on a different life outside. They'll last, if it's cool outside, they'll last a couple weeks at least, and then they'll start changing, which is always a neat part after that, you know.
What's been the most fascinating thing of the pumpkin carving to you?
Just coming up with a different face. I mean, I've done the pirate before, but people like it, and so I do it again. But whenever I do a different one I haven't done before, it's always neat. I've done everything from a football play. I'll leave the rind for the face mask and the helmet, and I'll kind of carve behind the rind, so there's a football player behind a pumpkin helmet. I like all aspects of it, really. Mm-hmm. I kind of tend to like the pumpkins that don't have, like this is kind of impressive. It's neat, but it's not one of my favorites because it looks like a nice carving on a pumpkin, whereas these here look like the pumpkins coming to life, sort of, because it kind of blends right into the pumpkin.
Yes.
And when you have the ears separate, it looks like a piece of artwork on the pumpkin.
I tend to like
faces like those here. I could teach someone how to do a simple face. And they, you know, anyone. I'm sure I could teach them how to do a very simple face. This tool here takes a little getting used to. But once you get used to using this, it's a lot easier than using a knife.
Well, Ray, what you're doing here in beautiful Bellaire, Michigan, is I think real neat, and teaching the young students this wonderful medium of pumpkin sculpting or carving, and who knows, it might be one of these masters pumpkin sculptors come out of your class. And we thank you so much for being part of Michigan Magazine, and we wish you continued success.
Thanks.
Vacation. Don't make the planning of it more than what you're trying to get away from. At NorthernMichiganCabinRentals.com, you can choose from over 2,500 cabins, cottages, lodges, resorts, lakefront vacation home rentals, and more. Whatever experience you're looking for, from rustic to luxury and everything in between. No more rustling with telephone books. No more endless internet searches. Just one site with over 2,500 Northern Michigan destinations. NorthernMichiganCabinRentals.com.
Well, thanks so much for joining us on Michigan Magazine. It's always our pleasure to meet up with you here on RFD-TV. It's autumn in Michigan, and the colors were fantastic. We thank all our viewers for sending in photos of their slices of autumn beauty. We had a great summer, and coming up, we'll be bringing you some fascinating stories never before seen, including a trip to an alpaca farm near Frankfort, Michigan, during National Alpaca Farm Days. And guess what happened when our cameras were rolling? Well, a Crystal Lake Alpaca Farm welcomed another baby alpaca into the fold, and we captured it all on video. You can see the entire birth at our YouTube channel, Spirit of Michigan. In honor of Alpaca Days, we're giving away a stuffed alpaca fur teddy bear, courtesy of Crystal Lake Alpaca Farm. All you've got to do to enter the giveaway is email your name, address, and phone number to iwatchmichiganmagazine@gmail.com. And we'll see you here next week for another edition of Michigan Magazine. We'd like to thank all those that help keep Michigan Magazine on the road. Thunder Bay Resort, a destination for all seasons with special events and packages. Thunder Bay Resort in Hillman. Cops and Donuts Bakery, downtown Clare, a winning combination. Cops and Donuts. Canyons Lakeside Resort and Marina, located on the shores of beautiful Sage Lake. Get away to their newly remodeled beautiful bed and breakfast or their historic 13-room hotel. Special events and activities for all ages. Call now or go online for more information on this Michigan treasure. Clemex Sales and Service on Mapes Road, west of Mile, your complete recreational vehicle sales and service connection. Visit their beautiful showroom of new and pre-owned ATVs, lawnmowers, power equipment, snowmobiles, utility vehicles, and more. Clemex Sales and Service is also the home of the American-made Victory motorcycle line on display at Clemex on Mapes Road, Mile. Hingeman Acres Canoe Livery and Resort on M33 just north of Mayo, catering to the outdoor enthusiasts. Cabins, canoes, kayaks, rafts, and more. Daytime or overnight trips along the world-famous Asabo River. A family getaway for over 75 years.